second book is extremely prasangik to this particular question because I've tried to show how divisions are not unique to the Hindu society and that they're equally present in other societies as well. The difference is other societies have a fantastic sense of who's an outsider to their worldview, which means unka shatrubodh jo hai crystal clear hai. And therefore, आपस में वो चाहे जितना भी लड़ते रहे. यू आस्क द क्वेश्चन. यस ओके. जब बाहर वाले की बात आ जाती है वो इकट्ठा हो जाते हैं. प्लीज आप इसको और थोड़ा एज अ परहैप्स अ ले स्टूडेंट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी ह्यूमन साइकोलॉजी जस्ट कंसिडर दिस. लीव एनी अदर सिविलाइजेशन एनी अदर संस्कृति और सभ्यता गिवन आर जर्नी diversity must be expected because there will be thought diversity as people go along. If it's at least 7000 years, assuming that's a very conservative number, you must expect vividhata without a doubt. To aap kya unity ke basis pe human psychology ko puri tarah se absorb karte rahenge? It's not going to happen. When people were fighting for Ayodhya, kisi ne ek dusre se ye nahi pucha ki aap आपकी कास्ट आइडेंटिटी क्या है, आपकी जात क्या है. Nobody was asking this question. They only came there as Ram Bhakts. Agarwals have died, Ahirs have died, Brahmins have died, everybody has died. When the police was firing at them, nobody asked each other, भाई ये यादव है या क्या है. ये सवाल किसी ने नहीं पूछा. So use this basic nuskha of human psychology कि आप लोगों को एक कॉज दीजिए टू रैली बिहाइंड. Nobody asked questions relating to language or caste. When Shivaji was fighting the Mughals, तब तक तो ये सवाल उठे ही नहीं थे. एक मिनट के लिए मान लेते हैं कि जितने भी हिंदू समाज के अंदर विकृतियां हमें पढ़ाई जाती हैं, ये उस कालखंड में भी था. एक मिनट के लिए मान लीजिए. But that did not stop the Hindus from uniting with each other to fight. At best, the division may have been political, but it was not caste-based or language-based. So the story that is told about the Battle of Panipat is how the Jats and the Marathas had a certain difference of opinion, or maybe they could have supported. I'm not getting into that. But ये इसलिए नहीं हुआ था कि ये जाट हैं वो मराठे हैं. That was not the reason. It was a political consideration of a different order altogether. So what I've tried to show through the first and the second books is the British man did not have to deal with the issue of caste. In Africa, and still the better part of Africa is either Christian or Muslim. He did not have to deal with the issue of caste in New Zealand. The Maoris are not to be found in as many numbers anymore. Canada, you are still finding mass graves, right? तो वहाँ पे क्या जाति प्रथा थी? So he invents excuses each time he goes to a particular jurisdiction to say, मैं यहाँ पे आपका उद्धार करने के लिए आया. And he is taking upon himself this benign burden, which is otherwise colonization. And he continues to justify his presence, saying, "Agar main yahan se nikal jaun, to aap ek dusre ko kaat ke marenge." Indians told this to each other when the freedom movement was going on. By the way, that means the man had successfully convinced the colonized people that his presence is necessary for us to stay united. That is the success of the Christian European colonizer. And the alpha level of the success or the beta level of the success is uske jaane ke baad bhi we are dealing with the very same issues. So I disagree with this proposition entirely. Two, how do you think the armed forces are structured? Every man is not fighting for the army, they are fighting for their core, their unit, their company, the color of that particular company. That's what they immediately relate to. It is federal unity. That is, the unit is fighting for the whole and the whole will fight for the unit. If that is how this structure operates to defend us, why is it important? Just aap isko aur ek step is tarko aage badhaiye. For you to be able to commit yourself to a particular identity or a parichay, wo aapke jitna nazdeek ho, it is easier for you to say this belongs to me. An amorphous Hindu identity makes no sense to most people Their sampradayas make sense to most people. Trick ye hai ki sampraday ke saath jo judav hai, it should never prevail over the larger dharmic unity. That is a different question altogether. उस यूनिटी को अचीव करने के लिए आपको सब आइडेंटिटीज को डिस्ट्रॉय करने की जरूरत नहीं है. जब आप ये करेंगे, सबसे बेसिक क्वेश्चन विच इवन कम्युनिज्म हैज नॉट बीन एबल टू आंसर टिल डेट एंड दैट्स व्हाई इट इज अ फेल्ड आइडियोलॉजी, वो किसी चीज को रिप्लेस करने की तो बात कर देते हैं, लेकिन उसको रिप्लेस किस चीज से करेंगे, व्हाट इज द सॉल्यूशन दैट नेवर कम्स आउट. ओके, लेट्स अज्यूम दैट आपने इस ग्रैंड हिंदू यूनिटी प्रोजेक्ट को भारत के पैमाने पर इसको अमल करना शुरू कर दिया, तो आप लोगों से क्या कह रहे हैं? Give up all your institutions which survive on those sampradayic identities. Chahe wo mandir ho ya jitne bhi prathayen ho, they are all connected to some tradition or the other. I suspect at least 50% of the audience has watched Kantara.
Yes.
Right. Okay. What most people perhaps may not have paid attention to is that folklore is also a hereditary practice. And the entire movie is about the son finding the way back to the profession of the father. And he's haunted by nightmares throughout the movie for his deviations. And finally he comes back to the way of the father, the prodigal son returns home. Now when you speak of the problem with hereditary structures, aap is argument ko forecourt mein leke jaiye. Let's see how does it work. Why do you need hereditary structures? I am not making an argument for why birth-based jati is right. I'm sure this is going to be confused with that. Let me try and explain this. When you inherit a particular tradition, aap is institution se jab bahar jate hain, you effectively have pride with respect to the institution which is your alma mater. You inherit those legacies. So any KGP guy, if he meets the other person, guy, girl, whatever it may be, we start with the standard motto of KGP. Of Kharagpur, which is KGP ka tempo high hai. That's how we use it. So that's how we interact with each other. How do we interact? The next level of interaction is, aap kaun se hall mein hai? What's your hostel? JCB, Jagdish Chandra Bose, Vishweshwaraya, that's how it goes. So you relate to the traditions of the hall that you come from. I am saying it's so surprising that we find it difficult to apply the very same logic to these structures. Because every जाति ट्रेडिशन रिप्रेजेंट्स अ नॉलेज ट्रेडिशन, उसको और उस बीज को बचाने की जिम्मेदारी उन्होंने ले रखी है, सो दैट सम फैमिली कंटिन्यूस ओवर अ पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम एंड देयर इज सम मेंबर ऑफ द फैमिली हू कांस्टेंटली सेज मैं इसकी रक्षा करूंगा. पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी मीन्स इट बिलोंग्स टू एवरीवन, करेक्ट? ओके, बट एवरी टाइम देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम इन दिस कंट्री, व्हिच इज द प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज फर्स्ट अटैक्ड? पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी. क्या आप उसको बचाने जाएंगे, अपने घर को बचाने जाएंगे? क्यों? ये तो आपकी भी है ना, ये संपत्ति आप सबकी है. बस को जलाया जा रहा है और आपके घर को जलाया जा रहा है, आप किसको चूज करेंगे? इन दोनों विकल्पों के बीच में आपका चुनाव किसका होगा? घर को होगा भाई, बिकॉज पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी इज नोबडीज प्रॉपर्टी, बिकॉज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन यू एंड पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी इज अमॉर्फस, इट एग्जिस्ट इन थिन एयर. बिकॉज आप कहेंगे ये देख लेगा, वो कहेगा ये देख लेगा, वरना स्टेट देख लेगी, बात खत्म. हिंदू यूनिटी ऐसे ही फेल होगा, क्योंकि आपने अंदर के जितने भी स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं उसको तोड़ दिया होगा और कोई इसकी रिस्पांसिबिलिटी नहीं लेगा. बट हु इज गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड थॉट लीडरशिप? दैट्स नॉट गोइंग टू हैपन. देयर इज अ रीजन दैट आवर इंडस्ट्रियल हाउसेस स्टिल सर्वाइव्ड, बिकॉज ऑफ द वैश्य ट्रेडिशंस एंड द सेफ्टी नेटवर्क्स एंड द गिल्ड्स दैट दे बिल्ट. अ ब्राह्मण विल नेवर हैव द कॉन्फिडेंस टू स्टार्ट अ बिजनेस एज मच एज अ बनिया डज, simply because of the inherited legacy of taking risks. Of course, there may be individual exceptions, but the existence of an exception only points to the existence of a rule. Departure ka matlab ye hai ki ek benchmark to ban gaya, wahan se aap deviations ko dekhte baithenge, but it is still a deviation, it's not the rule. If you happen to come from a certain background which says I will pursue knowledge, the rest of the society is going to take care of me, then you are not going to invest in risk-taking activity from a financial perspective. These are products of a pre-industrialized society. where the vocation of the father effectively becomes the vocation of the son. And I will say son, because at that point it was a male-dominated force. So you can accuse me of misogyny, but you can't change history. So considering that, question ab alag hona chahiye, which is, ek industrial age mein, kya is dharm ka koi mahatva reh chuka hai? That's a question you ask. But there are people who are still following their ancestors' practices and traditions. आपने ये डिसाइड कर लिया है कि आप मॉडर्न इकोनॉमी के साथ अब जुड़ जाएंगे तो ये आपका निजी डिसीजन है. यू कैन स्टॉप अदर्स फ्रॉम फॉलोइंग देयर प्रैक्टिसेस एज मच एज यू विल नॉट बी कंफर्टेबल विद देम इम्पोजिंग देयर स्ट्रक्चर ऑन यू. यू डोंट हैव द राइट टू इम्पोज योर वर्ल्ड व्यू ऑन देम बिकॉज दे आर सेइंग हम इस धारा से अलग रहेंगे. इफ यू आर विलिंग टू गिव द जरावाज इन अंडमान द राइट टू बी अवे फ्रॉम सिविलाइजेशन एज वी कॉल इट because you're saying these are certain cultures and ways of life that need to be protected, why can't you extend the very same benefit of doubt to others? Kyunki isme you will immediately be forced to look at it from the Marxist literature of class war, because unka seedha yehi allegation hoga that this entire structure was created only for oppression. That's exactly why Marxism's role in killing indigenous societies' native systems must be understood, and Bharat se behtar case study aapko is vishay mein nahi milega. Duniya bhar mein jaake ye native identity ki baat karenge, uski raksha karenge, because that's the underdog. Lekin Bharat mein aate hi, it is the native identity that becomes the oppressive identity. That's why in the first book I clearly show Marx apne aap keh raha hai that I may have my disagreements with colonization. बट उपनिवेशवाद का एक फैंटास्टिक ये कॉन्सिक्वेंस ये है कि एशियाटिक वेज ऑफ लाइफ विल बी डिस्ट्रॉयड, विच इज टू से इंडिया एंड चाइना विच आर द मेजर सिविलाइजेशंस, उनके अंदर के जितने भी सोसाइटल स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं, नॉलेज स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं, वो पूरी तरह से टूट जाएंगी. देयरफॉर कॉलोनाइजेशन इज इंपॉर्टेंट. नो वंडर मार्क्सिज्म इन दिस कंट्री एंड कम्युनिज्म इन दिस कंट्री इज कॉन्स्टेंटली पुशिंग द वेस्टर्न एजेंडा. व्हाट एन आयरनी. दे मे हैव अ प्रॉब्लम विद यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स but they otherwise don't have a problem foisting Western ideas in Bharat. That is the paradox in their positions. So, aise muddon pe theory se zyada practicals ki aur knowledge important ho jati hai, kyunki then you will ask, agar koi tradition aaj bhi zinda hai aur qayam hai, it's not because some fellow from a different tradition comes and says, main iski raksha karunga, isko aage leke jaunga. Those people have continued. 1200 years of butchery, savagery, destruction, burning of libraries, and this experience is replicated where in Persia, is replicated in Andalus, therefore Spain, please sit. In all these places this is replicated. Wahan ki sanskriti nahi bachi hai. Yahan pe kisne usko bachaya? Everyone takes care of their own traditions and says, hum iski raksha karenge. That is precisely why, despite all this, there is some continuity between how Bharat existed before 8th century and its current existence. आपको कुछ तो उसमें continuity नजर आ रहा है, क्योंकि किसी ने तो इसकी जिम्मेदारी ली कि हम इसकी रक्षा करेंगे. The problem with this discussion is that it is bound to be infused with the missionary British narrative of how untouchability was prevalent. मैं उसको कभी deny नहीं करूंगा. I'm not going to deny that something has happened. But मैं आपको और एक example भी इसके साथ दे दूंगा. सती का जो empirical evidence है, it is नगण्य, almost negligible. इन्होंने इसको भारत के बाहर पेश कर करके वहां से missionary contributions को यहां पे invite किया. The credit for this entirely goes to Claudius Buchanan, a Christian missionary, and I've pointed this out from his own literature, but you can read better literature, Dr. Meenakshi Jain's book on Sati. जगन्नाथ यात्रा को पूरी तरह से डिमराइज किया इस आदमी ने. सो ही गोज ऑन द वन हैंड टू से वेमेन आर बर्नड एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड पीपल कमिट सुइसाइड इन फ्रंट ऑफ द रथ यात्रा. और इस शापित लोगों को हमें बचाना है, और हम बचाएंगे कैसे? तो आपका हर प्रॉब्लम का सोल्यूशन यही है, तो इसका मतलब आपका मकसद यही है. व्हाई शुड आई चेंज माय पोजीशन नाउ? If you want to help a person, you can also do that without pulling away that person from his roots. But that is not your goal. Your goal is very different. So, ye sirf ek pretext hai. What is the anuvad for pretext in Hindi? Bahana is Urdu. What is in Hindi? Please find it. Decoloniality. So, I used anuvad and not tarjuman. So, therefore, sorry? Okay, fine. I do not know. Purvagra is it? Okay, fair enough. Theek. So, when you look at this larger picture, then the picture becomes very clear. आप जब तक भारत के कॉलोनाइजेशन की हिस्ट्री को अपने आप में पढ़ेंगे, which is to say, you look at it independent of anything else, you will always find mistakes with our society. But when you see the same culprit going to 10 different countries, from Latin America to Australia to New Zealand, he's converted everyone. Why am I supposed to not come to the conclusion, this is your end goal? Is the experience of the Northeast any different? No. Is the current day Andhra Pradesh any different? No. Is Punjab any different today? No. Res ipsa loquitur. Facts speak for themselves.